joining us this morning for our Sunday morning Q&A is Comptroller of Maryland, Peter Franchot. Good morning.
Terrific to be here.
Well, nice to have you here. And so let's start right off the bat. Tax-free shopping week starts today.
Yes, and this is Christmas in August. Everyone should get out and shop for clothing or shoes. Any item that costs less than $100, you can buy an unlimited number of items, and they're not subject to the state 6% sales tax.
So if it says $9.99, it's $9.99.
Exactly. And if it says $99, it's $99. They don't add on the 6%. And people, this is Christmas in August for small businesses because they get an enormous amount of
traffic,
consumer interest, shopping. It's great for Maryland families who have been hammered by the recession over the last 5 years. Everything's gone up in price, Jennifer.
I know it. Everything.
People's wages haven't gone up.
Right.
So everyone's looking for a deal. This is a deal all week. Sunday today till the following next Saturday, you can shop till you drop. If it's under $100, you can buy. You know, if you buy $1,000 worth of back-to-school clothes, you save $60.
Absolutely. Why can't we do this all the time?
Well, that's a, you know, other people that say, what about
it happens in other areas.
What about a tax-free month?
Mm-hmm. Right.
I personally am going to recommend to the legislature that we expand it to back-to-school supplies.
Yeah, that'd be great.
So it's backpacks and pencils
and pens,
other items like that. But we're going to lose about $5 million in tax revenue, so that's a big chunk of money. I think it's well worth it because we're giving Maryland families a break, and they, boy, do they deserve it. And then these small businesses, as I said, it's the second busiest shopping week of the year.
Next to Christmas.
This one, yeah.
Okay, so is this something you're going to recommend for the next tax-free
yes,
shopping
we're going to send
okay.
a report to the legislature about how successful this is, how popular it is, how important it is to Maryland families now. People plan their shopping around this. And it's not just back to school. It's any article of clothing or shoe.
Right, so if you don't have kids, you can still get in on the act. It
go
applies
shop.
To everybody.
You know, you and I should get out and buy our things.
Okay, let's go shopping right after 10 o'clock. Let's
yes.
hit it. Listen, you're going to also recommend that school starts later in the state of Maryland. I know at least in Carroll County, we're starting August 26th. So you're thinking about proposing a start after Labor Day.
Yeah, I want to go back to the way it used to be. Start school after Labor Day. Let Maryland families have a summer vacation with their kids, spend some quality time with them. So we're going to be recommending that this be a state policy, that we don't have this creep back into August. My goodness, some schools are going to be starting in July if we're not careful. So we've got to preserve summer vacation for the quality of life for our families and their children. We're so busy these days.
Terribly, yes.
That, you know, you got to slow down and realize that school isn't everything. There's family values that we need to protect. And for businesses, it's very important to be able to stay open for that summer tourist season.
Well, and the kids are off often, you know, for a part of that Labor Day week anyway. So
well, what happens is you come back, you go back in August. There's so many days off. They're so random and ad hoc during the year that parents, you know, are driven crazy by this. And I happen to believe that if we have that good summer vacation, it, you know, it really improves the quality of people's lives. But it's being studied by the legislature. There's a task force. We're going to put out a big report next week, which shows how important it is to the Maryland economy. In addition,
how important is it?
It's tremendous.
Can you give us any details?
East, well, Ocean City and Western Maryland tourism, August is the make or break month. And when they get it cut off because of this, everybody's going back to school in August, it has a big impact on the state's economy, and we'll be reporting on some of those figures.
If this gets some more support, is this a change that could be made by the next school year?
It sure could. Lots of states like North Carolina and others have longer school years, 200 school days. We only have 180 in Maryland. And they don't start school until after Labor Day, and they get out the first week in June. They just don't have all of these ad hoc service days during the year that drive families crazy because nobody knows why they're having them. All of a sudden, the kids are out of school and at home.
We have about a minute left, and I want to talk about this planned Greene Turtle expansion in Towson. It did not get the approval that was expected.
Well, it's going to be on the next Board of Public Works, August 21st. It's a request for a state loan of $240,000 to a Greene Turtle restaurant in Towson.
It's taxpayer dollars to pay for this expansion.
I love green turtles, but they have great wings. But this program is designed to help businesses in struggling communities like Cumberland out west or Chrisfields down on the Eastern Shore. It's not meant for Towson, and it certainly isn't meant for a sports bar in an affluent college town that's undergoing a big revitalization without the state help. So we're going to hopefully defeat that. We're trying to be tight with the dollar, trying to protect the taxpayers as far as getting them a rate of return that they deserve on their taxpayer investments. And giving money to the Green Turtle in Towson is a really bad idea.
All right. Thank you so much for coming in this morning and talking with us. We appreciate it. Have fun shopping.
Thank you.